This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Members of the German military were interned as prisoners of war in the United States during World War I and World War II. In all, 425,000 German prisoners lived in 700 camps throughout the United States during World War II. Contents 1. World War I. 2. World War II. 21. Background 22. The Geneva Convention 221. The camps 222. Work 23. Labor reports 24. Camp life 241. Rations 242. Entertainment and education 25. 5. Prisoner Resistance 26. Special Projects Division 27. After the War 3. See also. 4. References 5. External links. World War I. Hostilities ended 6 months after the United States saw its first action in World War I, and only a relatively small number of German prisoners of war reached the U.S. Many prisoners were German sailors caught in port by U.S. forces far away from the European battlefield. The United States Department of War designated 3 locations as POW camps during the war: Forts McPherson and Oglethorpe in Georgia and Fort Douglas in Utah. The exact population of German POWs in World War I is difficult to ascertain because they were housed in the same facilities used to detain civilians of German heritage residing in the United States, but there were known to be 406 German POWs at Fort Douglas and 1,373 at Fort McPherson. The prisoners built furniture and worked on local roads. The few dozen who died while incarcerated as POWs were buried at F.T. Douglas, Utah, the Chattanooga National Cemetery, and Fort Leon, Colorado. World War II background. After the United States entered World War II in 1941, the government of the United Kingdom requested American help with housing prisoners of war due to a housing shortage in Britain. The United States agreed to house them. 5. Although it was not prepared, its military had only brief experience with a limited POW population in the last World War, and was unprepared for basic logistical considerations such as food, clothing and housing requirements of the prisoners. Almost all German-speaking Americans were engaged overseas directly in combat efforts, and the American government feared the presence of Germans on U.S. soil would create a security problem and raise fear among civilians despite many wild rumors about how the Allies treated their prisoners. 86. Some Germans were pleased to be captured by the British or Americans. Fear of being captured by the Soviets was widespread, because they disagreed with Nazism or their nation's conduct of the war. 42-45,148,163. The prisoners were usually shipped in Liberty ships returning home that would otherwise be empty. 5. With as many as 30,000 arriving per month while they risked being sunk by their own U-boats on the ocean. Good treatment began with the substantial meals served aboard upon arriving in America. The comfort of the Pullman cars that carried them to their prison camps amazed the Germans. 32.70 As did the country's large size and undamaged prosperity. The Geneva Convention. The camp's typical barracks replica on display at the Camp Algona POW Museum. The office of the Provost Marshal General OPMG supervised. 8. The 425,000 German prisoners. They stayed in 700 camps in 46 states. A complete list may not exist because of the small, temporary nature of some camps and the frequent use of satellite or sub-camps administratively part of larger units other than barbed wire and watchtowers. The camps resembled standard United States or German military training sites. 33. The Geneva Convention of 1929 required the United States to provide living quarters comparable to those of its own military, which meant 40 square feet 371 square meters for enlisted men and 120 square feet 1,115 square meters for officers. XXII. If prisoners had to sleep in tents while their quarters were constructed, so did their guards. The 3 admirals and 40 generals in custody were sent to a Mississippi camp, where each had his own bungalow with garden. Government guidelines mandated placing the compounds away from urban, industrial areas for security purposes, in regions with mild climate to minimize construction costs, and at sites where POWs could alleviate anticipated farm labor shortages. Work a current 2013 sign outside the Owosso, MI, WW2 POW camp where German soldiers were held. The site had been, and then was again, the Owosso racetrack. The Geneva Convention's mandate of equal treatment for prisoners also meant they were paid American military wages. 78. They could work on farms or elsewhere only if they were also paid for their labor, and officers could not be compelled to work as the United States sent millions of soldiers overseas. The resulting shortage of labor eventually meant that German POWs worked toward the Allied war effort by helping out in canneries, mills, farms, and other places deemed a minimal security risk. Prisoners could not be used in work directly related to the military work, or in dangerous conditions. The minimum pay for enlisted soldiers was $0.80 a day, roughly equivalent to the pay of an American private in 1943. The government estimated that prisoner labor cost 50-75% of normal free labor, while language differences and risk of escape or unreliable work were disadvantages. Prisoner workers were available immediately on demand and in the exact numbers needed, while prisoners on average worked more slowly and produced less than civilians. Their work was also more reliable and of higher quality. 79, 82, 98 part of their wages helped pay for the POW program, and the workers could use the rest as pocket money for the camp canteen. They were paid in scrip. All hard currency was confiscated with other personal possessions during initial processing for return after the war as mandated by the convention, as money could be used during escape attempts. 78 The government received $22 million in 1944 from prisoner wages, and that year it estimated that it had saved $80 million by using prisoners in military installations. 6 Newspaper coverage of the camps and public knowledge were intentionally limited until the end of the war, in part to comply with the Geneva Convention and in part to avoid the fear of an enemy presence in such large numbers. While most citizens living near camps accepted the prisoners' presence, the government received hundreds of letters each week protesting their treatment. Many demanded that the POWs be immediately killed, a sentiment the regular casualty lists in American newspapers encouraged. The government had difficulty in persuading the public that treating the prisoners according to the Geneva Convention made it more likely that Germany would treat American prisoners well. Labor unions were the largest opposition to the use of the prisoner workers, citing the War Manpower Commission's rules that required union participation in worker recruitment whenever possible. 98-101 Given the wartime labor shortage, however, especially in agriculture, many valued their contribution. As late as February 1945, politicians in rural states asked the government for 100,000 more prisoners to work on farms. 6 Labor reports twice each month. Each prisoner of war camp was required to fill out WDAGO Form 19-21 and mail it to the office of the Provost Marshal General, Washington 25, D.C. Attention, Prisoner of War Operations Division. The report included the camp's name and address, the nationality of the prisoners, the total number of prisoners broken down by the number of officers, NCOs and privates, and the number of man days worked by project in that camp during the reporting period. Sometimes additional remarks were included on the back of the form. For example, the additional remarks from Dos Palos POW branch camp for the period ending the 12th of February 1946 stated 1692 waiting for repatriation. Camp closed the 12th of February 1946. Camp life. Life for the Germans in American POW camps was reportedly firm but fair. There were insufficient American guards, especially German speakers. They mostly supervised the German officers and NCOs who strictly maintained discipline. 33-34 The Germans woke their own men, marched them to and from meals, and prepared them for work. Their routine successfully recreated the feel of military discipline for prisoners. 34 Prisoners had friendly interaction with local civilians and sometimes were allowed outside the camps without guards on the honor system. 104,223 Black American guards noted that German prisoners could visit segregated restaurants that they could not. 52-53, luxuries such as beer and wine were sometimes available, and hobbies or sports were encouraged. Alex Funk, a former POW at Camp Algona, wrote, "We all were positively impressed by the USA. All had been won over to friendly relations with the USA. Indeed, unauthorized fraternization between American women and German prisoners was sometimes a problem. Several camps held social receptions with local American girls, and some Germans met their future wives as prisoners. 25-26 Rations. When I was captured, I weighed 128 pounds. After 2 years as an American POW, weighed 185. I had gotten so fat you could no longer see my eyes. Outside the camp, so guards were sometimes amenable to being bribed with them. One German later recalled that he gained 57 pounds 26. their German uniforms
119
in an idea seriously considered but ultimately rejected by American military officials, a few prisoners even volunteered to fight in the war against Japan. Camps built libraries to organize their reading material, and prisoners often purchased their own, but they never had enough reading material. With an average of one half book per prisoner, the YMCA printed thousands of copies of books for the camps, and even provided bookbinding material so camps could repair them due to frequent use. 113 camps had subscriptions to American newspapers, and every camp published its own newspaper with poetry and short stories, puzzles and games, listings of upcoming events, and classified ads. Camp authorities recognized the periodical's value in serving as creative outlets and as accurate indicators of the prisoners' views. The tone of their articles varied. Some promoted Nazi ideology and foresaw German victory, 110-111. Even as Germany's defeat neared in early 1945, 8 of 20 camp newspapers advocated Nazi ideology, 22. Many future German CEOs benefited from education they received as prisoners in the United States. Educated prisoners such as future German cabinet member Walter Hallstein, 150, taught classes on their areas of expertise including German, English and other foreign languages, business, and mathematics. The systematically taught courses were so successful that in May 1944 the German Ministry of Education and the OKW sent through the Red Cross detailed procedures for students to receive credit at German high schools and universities. Some prisoners took correspondence classes through local universities, and German universities also accepted their credits after returning home. Prisoner resistance relying on Germans to discipline themselves, while efficient, also permitted committed groups of Nazi prisoners to exist despite American attempts to identify and separate them, often members of the Afrika Korps who had been captured early in the war during Germany's greatest military successes. 152-151. They led work stoppages, intimidated other prisoners, and held secret kangaroo court for those accused of disloyalty. Those convicted were sometimes attacked or killed in a process known as the Holy Ghost. Most prisoner suicides were likely murders, while the American government executed 14 Germans after the war for murdering other prisoners in three incidents. Hundreds of such murders may have occurred. 158-159. Many devoted Nazis remained loyal to their political beliefs and expected a German victory until the Allies crossed the Rhine in March 1945. Their faith amazed prisoners captured during and after the Battle of Normandy, who had more realistic views of the likely outcome of the war. In turn, the earlier prisoners often viewed the others with contempt, calling them traitors and deserters. Fear of secret punishment by such men caused one prisoner to later state that there was more political freedom in the German army than in an American prison camp. He and other anti-Nazis were sent to Camp Ruston in Louisiana to protect them. XX 27114-115 quadrillion 151 trillion 153 billion 157 million 161,167 minus 168. While an Oklahoma camp received Waffen-SS and violent prisoners regardless of ideology often taunted their captors, such as saluting with Sieg Heils when forced to attend the lowering of the United States flag. They secretly celebrated Hitler's birthday and other Nazi holidays after the Americans banned them, and many became upset when Jewish American officers supervised them. 48-49-34-37. Less than 1% of all prisoners of war in America attempted to escape, however, about half the rate of Italian prisoners, 7 and less than the rate in the civilian prison system, and most were unsuccessful. The likelihood of an escapee returning to their forces overseas was very remote. The wish to avoid boredom was the reason most often given by those who attempted to escape. 132,152. Often hoping to reach Argentina, prisoners who died during escape attempts usually received military funerals with U.S. government provided Nazi flags on December 23, 1944. 25 German POWs broke out of Camp Papago Park in Arizona, not far from the Mexican border, by crawling along a 178-foot 54. The OPMG began a formal re-education program for German prisoners in fall 1943 named the Special Projects Division SPD and directed by a group of university professors. The program published Der Ruf, a prison newspaper edited by sympathetic POWs, and distributed books banned in Nazi Germany. The effort was kept secret because it probably violated the Geneva Convention's ban on exposing prisoners to propaganda, the possibility of German retaliation with American prisoners, and the expectation information that prisoners would reject overt re-education after VE Day, SPD began a series of rapid classes on democracy for some of the most cooperative prisoners. The 25,000 graduates of these classes returned directly to Germany, instead of being used for additional labor in Europe. 8-10, 22-169-170 SPD's efforts were unsuccessful. Many in the OPMG opposed the program, in part because they believed that changing most adults' basic philosophies and values was impossible and, if successful, might cause them to choose communism as an alternative. The American professors were almost entirely ignorant of German language or culture, as well as military and prison life. The reading material they prepared was overly intellectual and did not appeal to most prisoners, and Der Ruf was unpopular as it was essentially a literary journal with little current news. Surveys of camp prisoners found no change in the views of the vast majority of prisoners from the program. This was consistent with the unchanging level of confidence found in German soldiers immediately after their capture in Europe, despite steady German defeats. Their nation's complete defeat in the war and subsequent division into two countries were likely much more influential than SPD re-education in Germany's post-war rejection of Nazism. 8-11, 21-22. After the war, Dennis Wiles, aka Georg Gartner, July 4, 2009. Although they expected to go home immediately after the end of the war in 1945, the majority of German prisoners continued working in the United States until 1946, arguably violating the Geneva Convention's requirement of rapid repatriation, then spent up to three more years as laborers in France and the United Kingdom. XXII, 26-27. See also German prisoners of war in the United Kingdom. As the Geneva Convention no longer applied, and because of the atrocities discovered at concentration camps, prisoners' rations were cut and workloads were increased. Before being sent home, they were required to watch documentaries of the camps. Scholar Arnold Kramer noted that in his years of interviewing prisoners, he never met one who admitted to being a Nazi, and most Germans had some knowledge of the camps. However, how much those captured in North Africa knew of the Eastern Front, where most atrocities occurred, is unclear despite the delay in repatriation. Kramer reported that, "I've yet to meet a German prisoner who doesn't tell me that it was the time of their lives." Most Germans left the United States with positive feelings about the country where they were held, familiarity with the English language, and often with several hundred dollars in earnings. The funds benefited the post-war German economy. On their return, they had benefited from being held by a nation that largely did not hate German soldiers. A November 1943 poll found that 74% of Americans solely blamed the German government, not Germans, for the war. 8 After repatriation, about 5,000 Germans emigrated to the United States, and thousands of others returned later to visit, 248 such as Rüdiger von Wichmar, who lived in New York City for 14 years as the German permanent representative to the United Nations. Funk reported that the visitors did so as convinced Democrats due to their treatment. The camps in the United States are otherwise what the Associated Press later called an all-but-forgotten part of history, even though some former inmates went on to become prominent in post-war Germany. About 860 German POWs remain buried in 43 sites across the United States, with their graves often tended by local German women's clubs. Even in the communities which formerly hosted POW camps for Germans, local residents often do not know the camps ever existed. Reunions of camp inmates, their captors and local townspeople, such as those held in Maine and Georgia, have garnered press coverage and local interest for this unusual and infrequently mentioned aspect of the war. There is at least one recorded attempt by U.S. authorities to extract information from German POWs through torture. The camps for Germans were cited as precedents for various positions or failures of U.S. detainee policy during the debate over detainees at Guantanamo Bay detention camp. The U.S. government could not account for seven prisoners when they were repatriated. Georg Gartner escaped from a POW camp in Deming, New Mexico, on September 21, 1945, to avoid returning to his home region, occupied by the USSR. He assumed a new identity and lived quietly until surrendering on the Today Show to Bryant Gumbel in 1985. Although wanted by the United States government for years, Gartner lived under his adopted name Dennis Wiles, and wrote a book about his life, Hitler's Last Soldier in America. See also list of World War II prisoner of war camps in the United States. Building 98 United States Home Front during World War I. United States Home Front during World War II. German prisoners of war in the Soviet Union. German prisoners of war in Northwest Europe. Barbwire Bull. Classic references. Carrot, America in the Great War, Eyewitness to History. WYWitnessToHistoricom, retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, blow up Corman, interned gunboat, The New York Times, April 8, 1917. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, Jockelson, Mitchell, The War Department, Keeper of Our Nation's Enemy Aliens During World War I, presentation to the Society for Military History Annual Meeting, April 1998. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, Cunningham, Raymond K., Jr., Fort Douglas War Prison Barracks 3 Prisoners of War, University of Utah Records Center. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, Cunningham, Raymond K., Jr., German Prisoners 507 Strong, Join Intern Comrades, University of Utah Records Center. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, Lloyd, R. Scott, Wreath Laying Honors World War I German Prisoners Buried at Fort Douglas, Deseret News, November 14, 2010. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. Copeland, Susan, Foreign Prisoners of War, The New Georgia Encyclopedia. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, Janiski, Bob, Pruning the Parks, Chattanooga National Cemetery, National Parks. Traveler.com, December 25, 2009. Retrieved March 29, 2011. Carrot, Cemeteries, Fort Leone National Cemetery, United States Department of Veterans Affairs. Retrieved March 29, 2011. Carrot, A. B. Bowman, Michael, World War II Prisoner of War Camps, The Encyclopedia of Arkansas History and Culture. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. Rabin, Ron, 1995. The Barbed Wire College, Reeducating German POWs in the United States During World War II. Princeton University Press. ISBN R. Nazi POWs in America History Channel, 18 April 2004. Carrot, A. B. Sitko, Glenn, German POWs in North America, The Journey to Prison Camps, U-BoatNet. Retrieved 6 September 2012. Carrot, A. B. Flynn, Jacob, German POWs kept in Central Florida during World War II, West Orange Timescom. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. D. Hoffield, Michael, World War II Camp Had Impact on City, Fort Wayne News Sentinel, December 15, 1990. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. Camp Algona POW Museum. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. Sitko, Glenn, German POWs in North America, U-BoatNet. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. Pepin, John, POW Camps in the UP, The Mining Journal, Marquette, Michigan. Retrieved March 28, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. Camp Algona POW Museum, Questions and Answers of Alex Funk, accessed April 2, 2011. Carrot, A. B. C. D. Sitko, Glenn, German POWs in North America, Recreation, U-BoatNet. Retrieved 6 September 2012. Carrot, Waters, Michael R., Mark Long, and William Dickens. Lone Star. Stalag, German Prisoners of War at Camp Hearn, 2004, Texas A. York Times, September 11, 1985. Retrieved 14 January 2008. External links. Camp Atterbury, Italian and German POW Camp. Indiana Camp Algona POW Museum. Iowa Budu, extensive overview of World War I POW life. Article describing World War I POW Camp at Fort McPherson, Munsey's Magazine, 1918. VE World War I Home Fronts. Theaters. European Balkans. Western Front. Eastern Front. Italian Front. Middle Eastern. Gallipoli, Sinai and Palestine. Caucasus. Persia. Mesopotamia. South Arabia. African. Southwest East. Cameroon. Togoland. North Asian and Pacific. Tsingtao. German. New Guinea and Samoa at Sea. North Atlantic. U-Boat Campaign. Mediterranean. North Sea. Baltic. Indian. Pacific. Italy. Japan. Montenegro. Portugal. Romania. Russia. Russian Empire. Russian Republic. Serbia. United States. Central Powers. Germany. Austria. Hungary. Ottoman Empire. Bulgaria. Timeline. Pre-war conflicts. Scramble for Africa. 1880-1914. Russo-Japanese War. 1905. First Moroccan Tangier Crisis. 1905-06. Agadir Crisis. 1911. Italo-Turkish War. 1911-12. French Conquest of Morocco. 1911-12. First Balkan War. 1912-13. Second Balkan War. 1913. Prelude. Origin. Sarajevo Assassination. Anti-Serb Riots in Sarajevo. July Crisis. Autumn 1914. Battle of the Frontiers. Battle of Cer. First Battle of the Marne. Siege of Tsingtao. Battle of Tannenberg. Battle of Galicia. Battle of the Masurian Lakes. Battle of Kolubara. Battle of Sarakamish. Race to the Sea. First Battle of Ypres 1915. Second Battle of the Masurian Lakes. Second Battle of Ypres. Battle of Gallipoli. Second Battle of Artois. Battles of the Isonzo. Great Retreat. Second Battle of Champagne. Kosovo Offensive. Siege of Kut. Battle of Luz 1916. Erzurum Offensive, Battle of Verdun Lake, Narok Offensive, Battle of Asiago, Battle of Jutland, Battle of the Somme, Brusilov Offensive, Baranovichi Offensive, Battle of Romani Monastir Offensive, Battle of Transylvania 1917, Capture of Baghdad, First Battle of Gaza, Zimmerman Telegram, Second Battle of Aris, Kerensky Offensive, Third Battle of Ypres, Paschendaele, Battle of Maricesti, Battle of Caporetto, Southern Palestine Offensive, Battle of Cambrai, Armistice of Erzincan 1918, Operation Faustschlag, Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, Spring Offensive, Second Battle of the Marne, Battle of Baku, 100 Days Offensive, Vardar Offensive, Battle of Megiddo, Third Transjordan Attack, Meuse Argonne Offensive, Battle of Vittorio Veneto, Battle of Aleppo, Armistice of Salonika, Armistice of Mudros, Armistice of Villa Giusti, Armistice with Germany, Other conflicts, Mexican Revolution 1910-20, Somaliland Campaign 1910-20, Libyan Resistance Movement 1911-43, Meretz Rebellion 1914-15, Zayan War 1914-21, Indo-German Conspiracy 1914-19, Senussi Campaign 1915-16, Volta Boni War 1915-17, Easter Rising 1916, Anglo Egyptian Darfur Expedition 1916, Khaosan Revolt 1916-17, Russian Revolution 1917, Finnish Civil War 1918. Post-war conflicts, Russian Civil War 1917-21, Ukrainian Soviet War 1917-21, Armenian Azerbaijani War 1918-20, Georgian Armenian War 1918, German Revolution 1918-19, Revolutions and Interventions in Hungary 1918-20, Hungarian Romanian War 1918-19, Greater Poland Uprising 1918-19, Estonian War of Independence 1918-20, Latvian War of Independence 1918-20, Lithuanian Wars of Independence 1918-20, Third Anglo-Afghan War 1919, Egyptian Revolution 1919, Polish-Ukrainian War 1918-19, Polish-Soviet War 1919-21, Irish War of Independence 1919-21, Turkish War of Independence, Greco-Turkish War 1919-23, Turkish-Armenian War 1920, Iraqi Revolt 1920, Polish-Lithuanian War 1920, Vlora War 1920, Franco-Syrian War 1920, Soviet-Georgian War 1921, Irish Civil War 1922-23, Aspects, Opposition, Pacifism, Anti-War Movement, Deployment, Schlieffen Plan, German Plan 17, French Warfare, Military Engagements, Naval Warfare, Convoy System, Air Warfare, Cryptography, Horse Use, Poison Gas, Railways, Strategic Bombing Technology, Trench Warfare, Total War, Christmas Truce, Last Surviving Veterans, Civilian Impact, Atrocities, Prisoners, Casualties, Economic History, 1918 Flu Pandemic, Destruction of Kalisch, Rape of Belgium, German Occupation of Belgium, German Occupation of Luxembourg, German Occupation of Northeastern France, Ober-Ost Ottoman People, Armenian Genocide, Assyrian Genocide, Pontic Greek Genocide, Blockade of Germany, Women, Australia, Popular Culture, German Prisoners of War in the United States, Agreements, Partitioning of the Ottoman Empire, Sykes-Picot Agreement, Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne, French-Armenian Agreement, Damascus Protocol, Paris Peace Conference, Venizelos-Titoni Agreement, Treaties, Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, Treaty of Lausanne, Treaty of London, Treaty of Neuilly, Treaty of Saint-Germain, Treaty of Sèvres, Treaty of Trianon, Treaty of Versailles, Consequences, Aftermath, 14 points, League of Nations, World War I Memorials, Centenary Commemorations, Category Portal, World War I at Wiktionary, World War I Textbooks at Wikibooks, World War I Quotations at Wikiquote, World War I Source Texts at Wikisource, World War I Images, Mediterranean and Middle East, North Africa, East Africa, Italy, West Africa, Atlantic, North America, South America, Casualties, Military Engagements, Conferences, Commanders, Participants, Allies, Leaders, Australia, Belgium, Brazil, Canada, China, Cuba, Czechoslovakia, Denmark, Ethiopia, France, Free France from June 1940, Greece, India, Italy from September 1943, Luxembourg, Mexico, Netherlands, New Zealand, Norway, Philippines, Commonwealth, Poland, South Africa, Southern Rhodesia, Soviet Union, United Kingdom, United States, Puerto Rico, Yugoslavia, Axis and Axis-aligned leaders, Albania, Bulgaria, Reorganized National Government of the Republic of China, Independent State of Croatia, Finland, Germany, Hungary, Free India.